So this is an image we captured last week for a real estate development company. I'm going to show you two simple methods to draw property boundary lines using the Polygon Tool and the Pen Tool. Almost 90% of the time we use these two methods to quickly draw and highlight the property lines and boundaries. So the first method I'm going to show you is the Polygon Tool. Select the Polygon Tool and check the settings in the top menu. For fill, I have it set to no fill, no color. For the stroke color, I use white. The width I set to 50 pixels to start with, so I can see it clearly. For the sides, you can use 4 for a square or rectangle block, or 3 for a triangle. I'm going to use 5 for this image, since the real estate developer wanted a sliced section at the bottom. Once done, click anywhere on the image using your left mouse button and drag to create your polygon shape. Once you have your shape created, you'll probably notice that you can't move the corners. So to get the corners into the right location, we're going to use the direct selection tool. Once selected, click anywhere on the line, then drag each corner into the correct position for the property, aligning the boundaries or the area of interest. Once done, you can adjust the width and line from the top menu. I prefer to use around 20 pixels, depending on the perspective of the image or the height of the drone image. Option 2 is to use the Pen Tool. The Pen Tool is great for boundaries that have multiple sections or difficult areas to cover with the line. As an example, we'll draw the same boundary line, but go around the house as if the house was not for sale and only the land was for sale. We're going to start by selecting the Pen Tool. From the top menu, the same settings apply, so check them if needed. To start, use the left mouse button and click on the starting point. Go to your next point and click to connect the line. I'll do the same for all points where I want the line to go. I do this quickly and roughly since I'll be moving each point into the correct location shortly. To complete the boundary, join the last point to the start position. Once you've completed the Pen Tool shape, we'll do the same alignment by going to the direct selection tool and selecting it. Click on the line, then move each point into the correct location. Then adjust your width, color, and fill if required from the top menu. So these two are my go-to options when creating simple but effective property boundary lines for real estate development companies. I like to keep it as simple as possible with the least amount of effort on my part. There are so many different ways to do this, including using the lasso, paintbrush, and selection tools in Photoshop. So let me know in the comments what your preferred method is, or if you have another option. Please don't tell me use the line tool. Don't be this guy. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.